That's been a long time since I did this. How do you talk to a camera again? Isolation have been going okay, slightly going crazy. You hearing voices? No, are you? Probably nothing. If you're seeing this, I found the YouTube upload button. If you're like the rest of the world, then you probably have not been flying as much this year as you would like to, and you probably have a lot of fuel that you wish you used, but never did. Me too. So I wanted to make a small experiment to figure out if there is a way to determine if your fuel is still good. Primarily if water has been absorbed into the fuel. The way I'm gonna try this is to use this. This is copper sulfate. I'll put the chemical name here. You'll notice that this one is blue. It's a nice dark blue. If you dry it out in an oven or something similar, you get this nice, well, it's kind of white, more like white gray. So the idea is that since the color here is determined on how much water there is, it turns blue because it absorbs humidity from the air. Maybe we can put some fuel on it and see if it changes color. I do know for some initial experiments that the water reacts instantly. I want to do a time lapse over a few hours, maybe 12 hours or so, and see if it if the fuel or oil and other stuff we're going to use is will change color over time. So behind me, not set up yet, I'll set up a camera with a time lapse, filming on a glass full of this and some liquid. Hopefully we'll be able to see on the time lapse how the different liquids changes color. That's probably more than we need. But yeah, as you can see here, grid, I'll put some labels on it, and then we'll have these cups. How many different ones we'll have. Or maybe I'll space them out a bit. More cups if we have more chemicals. I'll come up with what I want to add there, and then I'll give you guys a picture of it.
So the time lapse here is running. You see the 10% reacted almost instantly. And then here the 5% is reacting. And now the 1% is reacting, and then shortly thereafter the fresh fuel and the old fuel is reacting. At the end we will see that the methanol is reacting.
You just have seen the time lapse of the fuel reacting, and as you can see from the video, it actually reacts in an expected pattern. So the one with most water in reacts first, so 10% water kicks in almost immediately. And then after that the 5, and then the 1, and then after that the 2 normal fuels. It's quite interesting to see that this one of them was really old fuel, stored in a garage for maybe 2 years. And then one of them was freshly mixed, like a few weeks old fuel. And they reacted instantly. So that tells me that those two will have the same water content. So this old fuel that I had in the garage for a few years, it should not be contaminated with water. At the very end you see the pure methanol react, and I actually think the reaction there is because it dries out. If you look carefully in the video, it seems like that's the case. It's also worth noting that there's a clear distinction between the 1% and the 5%. That means that maybe we can repeat this experiment and then go into even finer details, like how low a percentage would you be able to tell the difference with? Could you tell the difference with half a percentage, like 0.2%? So it might be worth doing this experiment again. I don't have any numbers on how much water fuel is expected to absorb, or how much water is too much water in fuel, because both methanol and I think also nitromethane will absorb some water just from the humidity in the air. All in all, I think it was quite an interesting experiment, because I think you can see and say something clever about how much water is actually in the fuel from this. You could use this experiment to tell if your old fuel is good or not. It will only require a known good fuel, like a fresh batch of fuel. So you take in one cup, you take your old fuel, and in another cup you take the new known good fuel. And then you add copper sulfate to them, and then you can leave them overnight. Maybe set your phone to record them. I think most modern phones can do a time lapse. And then next morning you'll know by the reaction time difference if it's a good fuel or not. If your old fuel reacts first, then maybe throw it away. I hope you found this video interesting. I'll try and make some more videos of stuff you can do when there's no competitions around. No promises. See you next time.